Hello, namaste, konnichiwa, welcome to Sunny Sensei. In this lesson, we will prove a fundamental property of circles. The tangent at any point of a circle is perpendicular to the radius through the point of contact. Let's get started. So, what do we have? We have a circle with center O and a tangent XY touching the circle at point A. Our goal is to prove that the radius OA is perpendicular to tangent XY. Now let's move on to the proof. First, pick a point B on the tangent XY such that B is different from point A. You can pick any point on XY, but just make sure this point doesn't overlap with point A. Now connect center O to B and let this line segment OB and the circle intersect at point C. Now the length of OB can be expressed as a sum of OC and CB. We also have OC equal to OA. Both are radii of the same circle. This means we can replace OC with OA to get. The length of segment CB is a positive quantity, which means OB is definitely longer than OA. We can rewrite this as OA is less than OB. Now, pause for a moment and have a careful look at this expression. Remember, B can be any point on XY that is different from point A. This means, for each of these possible points, OA will always be the shortest distance between O and tangent XY. And here is another key fact. The shortest distance from a point to a line is always the perpendicular distance. That's why OA must be perpendicular to XY. And with that, we have proven that the tangent at any point of a circle is perpendicular to the radius through the point of contact. But hold on. Now it's time to put your knowledge to the test at the challenge station. Here's the problem. From an external point P, two tangents, PQ and PR, are drawn to a circle with center O, touching the circle at points A and B, respectively. A third point C lies on the circle. If angle APB equals 50 degrees, find angle ACB. Please pause the video and give it a try. Alright, let's work through it. We have a circle with tangents. We just learned that tangents are perpendicular to the radius through the point of contact. So, angle PAO equals 90 degrees and angle PBO also equals 90 degrees. What's next? Let's look at quadrilateral PAOB. We know the sum of interior angles of a quadrilateral is 360 degrees. We already have 50 degrees, 90 degrees, and 90 degrees. So, 50 degrees plus 90 degrees plus angle AOB plus 90 degrees equals 360 degrees. 50 plus 90 is 140, and 140 plus 90 is 230. So we have angle AOB is 130 degrees. Now let's move to the circle. Point A and B lie on the circle. These points subtend angle AOB at the center and angle ACB on the circumference. This is where we apply the central angle theorem. According to this theorem, the central angle, angle AOB, is twice the angle at the circumference angle ACB. So, angle AOB equals 2 times angle ACB. 2 times angle ACB is 130 degrees. Or, angle ACB equals 130 degrees divided by 2. Or, 65 degrees. We are done. If you found this lesson useful, please like, share, and subscribe to Sunny Sensei. Drop a comment with any questions or thoughts. I would love to hear from you. Thank you for watching, and I will see you again soon.